Hello and welcome to the show. My name is Alex and this is TechFlow. Before we get into the video, welcome to 2017. Let's do this. So here invited me over to CES to talk about their new technology, and can we all just take a moment to appreciate this incredible booth. Inside the booth there were various demos set up, all the way from VR to automated robot parks. We'll come into those a little bit later, but first let's brush over what here call the Future Mobility Visualizer. This interactive table has been designed to demonstrate common trends in a city both now and in the future.
It's pretty much a look into the future of how here can plan mobility for the future.
So on this immersive touchscreen table we can see a map of a city in Germany, displaying everything from cars, bikes, and public transport. And with all this location data, here can gather the average speed of traffic, things like how the weather affects transportation, for example, more taxis on the road and less bikes, as well as CO2 emissions and much more. Here are also trying to demonstrate what they call optimal routes. To put it simply, for example, to take you on your route, so let's say from your current location right now to your end destination, let's say you want to go to town, well, it can make sure the lights are green, make you avoid traffic jams, and they're even trying to take it a step further with public services like the refuse system only picking up bins that are 70% or more full. Now, the reason they do this is to keep the lorry bins off the road and put the lorry bins on a route, an automatic route which is going to take them exactly where they need to only go and collect the bins that are 70% or more full. This, well, in conjunction with reducing CO2 emissions, helps traffic as well.
The next demo is titled Here HD Live Map. This is a data-enriched map for autonomous vehicles. Now, this is cool.
Now, by using sensors in cars, here are already working with Audi, BMW, and Mercedes already, three massively recognizable car brands. So with these sensors, cars can report things like free and taken parking spots to other users, and not just notify others this is roadworks, but tell them the exact lanes that are closed and tell them if there's been an ambulance spotted, all automatically by the car sensors. So for example, right now, say if there's a traffic jam outside or some roadworks, you know, they may put up a nice little sign to tell you that there's going to be some roadworks in a mile or so, but you don't know what those roadworks are going to be. You don't know what that traffic jam's going to be. You don't know if someone's been injured, if there's an ambulance involved, or if it's two lanes merging into one lane and that's how the roadworks are going to be going forward, or if it's temporary traffic lights. Well, with these sensors in cars, the cars that are near the incident already can alert the cars behind them that ahead it's temporary traffic lights, or they can alert them that all the lanes are splitting into one lane so everybody needs to slow down. Really intelligent stuff. The next demo was VR. I put on the goggles and walked through a visual demo of the cars with sensor data reporting back to a server, letting other vehicles know about free parking spots, traffic incidents, and the ability to have LED road signals to be changed on the fly to warn people about potential accidents and things like lane merging. By using the sensors in the cars that we've already talked about, here can identify things like, as well, natural hazards, like icy roads, by accessing the car's ABS data and reporting it back to cars that are on the same route. So say if there's been four or five cars that have gone over a patch of ice on the road and it's activated all four of those cars' ABS system, the system can then alert cars behind them that watch out, because the four cars in front have had their ABS activated, there must be something slippy on the road, you may want to slow down. Now, the last and most simple demonstration was a scaled down warehouse with robots navigating the space, moving and dropping containers to designated locations. Here we're demonstrating the precision down to a few centimeters. Really precise. Here we're explaining that this is just a scaled down warehouse. Now think about it in the future. Imagine if there's warehouses, but it's all automated. You've got machines going and picking up containers and dropping things off where they need to be, and it's all automated, not a human involved at all. It's amazing to get a glimpse into the future of mobility, how it makes roads safer, saves lives, cuts down on traffic jams and emissions, while saving time and money at the same time. Now, if you want to try and experience a little bit of this for yourself, here actually do have a navigation app. You can download it. It's called Here We Go. You can download it in the App Store. It has features like offline maps, Optimal's way of traveling, live traffic information, and like, you know, nearby POIs, points of interest. Now, if you're super interested in this sort of stuff, I'm gonna put his blog post in the description. You can go ahead and check that out if you want to. But again, massive thank you to HERE for sending me out to Las Vegas for CES and letting me wander around and demonstrate to me their awesome booth and what they're doing to the future of transportation. Absolutely incredible stuff. But for now, guys, my name's been Alex. This has been TechFlow. Catch you in the next one. Let's get that.